on today's diecast review, we're going to be taking a look at Tyler Reddick's 2020 Realtree car. A car that's so beautiful, amazing, heck, camouflaged, it's so cool you can't even see it. Let's go ahead and hop to the review. Howdy folks, it is Diecast Buffet here again. Welcome to another NASCAR Diecast video. And I've been wanting to review this diecast so freaking bad. I thought this car was canceled. I thought it was done. When I seen on the shipment reports that the Realtree Tyler Reddick diecast was coming off the boat from China, I said, holy crap. Wow. Talk about one epic diecast. I mean, whoa. The freaking day glow on this thing is absolutely beautiful. It's definitely a reflective hunter safety orange. The camouflage all over this diecast, the white kind of whooshes and transitions. Really cool stuff here. Kind of like a brushstroke pattern. Very reminiscent of the Kevin Harvick 29 Realtree cars. And holy cow, man. Talk about one epic freaking diecast. And without further ado, make sure to give the video a big thumbs up. Let's go and get this Realtree Camaro out of the box. Alrighty, folks, brand new out of the box, and holy cow, man, this thing, I mean, it got a little bit of a decal, or I think it's actually inside the windshield. Eh, big deal. What a freaking awesome diecast here, man. I'm so happy they finally got an alternate paint scheme released for Tyler Reddick. Look, we've been stuck with that same Caterpillar car in every NASCAR Dallas Cup Series race since the year of the flood. Well, that changes tomorrow at 5 p.m. No, 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. You can check out this diecast and unscripted diecast racing. You can see how this car performs tomorrow at the Bass Pro Shops 500 at Atlanta Motor Speedway. Unscripted diecast racing. What a awesome freaking car here, fellas. I mean, the giant Realtree logo right there on the hood with that camouflage pattern underneath it. Look, as a guy from Texas, right? I tell you what, I love Realtree, okay? I absolutely love Realtree camouflage, and to get a die cast of it and to still see them in the sport is really awesome stuff. And if you want to get this die cast, link down below, free shipping. Any orders $20 or more, use promo code DieCastBuffet at Circle B Diecast or Plan B Sales. No tax either. Best deal in NASCAR diecast. And it works for 124s, 164s, t-shirts, hats, anything NASCAR merchandise. You get free shipping, fellas. And it is the cheapest freaking prices. This isn't the stupid crap you see on eBay when it's like $12 for a diecast. Now we're talking the rock bottom freaking prices, my dude. How do you think I get all this stuff? I get free shipping every time. You get Richard Childress Racing right there, 3M, Sunoco. Oh, that's right, he's a rookie. got Sunoco, Rookie of the Year, Sunoco. Camaro ZL1, got the number 8. Just look at the transitions here, that beautiful kind of like it's like a paintbrush stroke with that little bit of a Dago outlining. But I just love how it wraps around the front valence, and it kind of meets in the middle right here with the kind of dark brush background, the camouflage. Very, very sharp. The Chevrolet bow tie is a little bit off-center, but you know what that is. It's kind of expected, unfortunately. Over here to the left side, and I mean, if you have a diecast series, like I said, this is going to be in that Sunday race tomorrow, Easter Sunday. Oh, happy Easter for everybody, you know, maybe you're watching across the globe, who freaking knows, this diecast is going to be in that race, and it's like, I've been saying this for months, Tyler Reddick deserves an alternate paint scheme released. The guy races so many different paint schemes, just like Austin Dillon. Guess what? No freaking paint schemes released, except for this one. Austin Dillon's still the same Dow chemical car. Oh, finally, we get the Bass Pro Shops car. That was DMP'd, and it put in the authentic slide. So there could have been probably at least 10 different paint schemes for Reddick or Austin Dillon. Unfortunately, we only got a couple, but that's okay. At least we got some, though. Got Tyler Reddick there, Lucas Oil, Sherwin Williams, looks like Freightliner, whatever the biff that is, Pinnacle, KCMG, whatever the biff that is, Realtree. God, I love seeing that Realtree on the side of a stock car. I really wish, though, they would have took the font they used for the Jeff Burton Donington throwback for Reddick and put that on the car for 2021. Got Red Cap, Osco, PTC, Cometic, Cheddar's. Every time I see the Cheddar's logo on his car, I think of Fort Worth. Because every time I go to Fort Worth for Texas Motor Speedway, gotta have some Cheddar's. I love that place. I hope to God they still have their mac and cheese the next time I go back. Because they told me, we don't carry our mac and cheese. It's so freaking good, bro. They bake it. It's not some crap they stir in a pot. They actually bake it. They put breadcrumbs. Holy sheesh, that crap's good. You got Cat right there. Cat Skid Steer Loader. You got Tame the Beast, and I am second. American Ethanol. Cup Series Goodyear Race Car. Over here to the back end of this good car. Let's see. Stream Now. What the biff? I'm not sure what that means. Stream Now. Real Tree Stream, I guess. I have no clue. I got Okuma here. I got the Rookie Stripes, which I love a good Rookie Stripes on the back end of a car that's painted like a dark color because it really pops out, you know? I would say the accent color for this car being the Hunter Safety Orange, the Day Glow really fits in well with it, with the white and the black and the camouflage. Very, very sharp stuff. I like the ZL1 1LE. Camaro, got the number 18. I love the white Camaro font. Very clean. Over to the right side of this diecast, and oh goodness, I mean, holy moly, somebody took a hammer and beat the right rear end. I mean, what the biff? The whole Realtree logo is going down the Price is Right mountain here, as Robbie Nooney would say. You could definitely see the decal crease here. This is something you would never see in 2005, 2003, 04, etc. When they used to produce 77,000 diecasts of one mold and one paint scheme of one driver. It was not uncommon to see, oh God, 70 or 60 or 50,000 diecasts made of a Michael Waltrip Patriotic 164 Elite. That's just one production run. That's not including Winner Circle, Club Cars, Action Racing Collectibles, the RCCAs. Holy sheesh, the Cornucopia, the Team Calipers, the freaking, the 118s, 132, I mean, good, 124s, the Haulers. I mean, you think about it, they would probably produce over a million freaking Michael Waltrip diecast every season in the early 2000s. When you put all the different production runs together, it is a absolute cornucopia bedlam of freaking diecast. It was crazy, man. Got the number 8 right there. I love how the outline to the number 8 is very thin, right? So it puts an emphasis on that Day Glow, and it really pops here. Like, I feel like with this one, I don't know, it feels like the outline's a little bit thicker. It probably has some shadowing or something to it, but I really like that bold font to it. But I can't help but think, if I look at it from this angle, it kind of looks like a blocky David Rudiman 00. I like the Realtree right there. It kind of blends in very nice with the camouflage. And can we get more camouflage in NASCAR? Like, here's my thing. Bass Pro Shops, Martin Truex Jr., why don't y'all run a cool, like, camouflage paint scheme or something? I think that'd be really cool. I got Reddick right there and Realtree Timba. Realtree Timba right there on the deck lid. So, talk about one epic freaking diecast here. And it's such a cool car that you might not even be able to see it. I mean, it is camouflage, after all. Thank y'all so much for watching the video. Make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Like, comment, and subscribe. And if you want to help out the channel, make sure to go shop at Circle B Diecast or Plan B Sales. Use that promo code, fellas. You get free shipping. 2021 diecasts are releasing later this month. So it's going to be the last few days of April or the first week of May. So I would go ahead and get your pre-orders in. We got some Harvick diecasts coming in. The Roush Fenway gang. Heck, a little bit later in May, we're going to be getting the Interstate Batteries car for Kyle Busch. There's going to be a lot of fans excited about that Rowdy Busch diecast. So go ahead and get your pre-order set. Not to mention all the 124s are going to be releasing. So exciting times, fellas. We're finally getting into the new NASCAR diecast season. I am freaking hyped. Thank y'all so much for watching. Hope you're having a blessed one. This diecast is so cool, you can't even see it. Diecast Buffet. Signing off.